What's up, guys? So if you're watching this, you are new to the channel, and a lot's changed since I started. So I'm redoing the channel trailer. I'm gonna talk about kind of who I am, where I came from, and what's the purpose of what I'm doing, why I'm doing what I'm doing. So who am I? I'm Joe. I'm a husband, a father, and a pastor. I run this online social media that I've labeled Tattooed Theist. Where did I come from? I'm gonna do this really short just because I'll do a full testimony at another time. So essentially, I was a heroin addict for 5 years. I ended up in prison for about 4 years, and now I am just finishing my undergraduate degree in ministerial leadership with a minor in pastoral leadership. And in the spring, I'm going on to get my graduate degree, my master's degree, from a theological seminary in Chicago. What is the ministry? What am I doing? So really, it started as an Instagram profile where it was like an apologetic profile. I was really into apologetics. So all my followers were atheists. Everybody I was following was atheist, and we just debated all the time, constantly. It then kind of took a shift where it became a ministry in and of itself, where a lot of Christians were being drawn to it, and the questions were just getting so crazy and intricate and theological, and people wanted answers to things. And so I decided to make the shift into making it an actual Christian ministry that wasn't really apologetic in nature, that it was more of something that I'd be willing to talk about anything that people wanted me to talk about. So that's what it became. It became a place where people would come to ask questions that the church won't answer. Things that are too edgy, too controversial, or that might offend somebody that the physical church won't preach about, won't teach about, and won't tell you about. That's what I do. That's where I come in. So every week on Instagram, I post a list, a topic list. The topic list has over 200 topics now. So every week when I post it, you can either comment a new topic and I add it to the list, and you also vote on what you want me to do the video on that week. And whatever gets the most votes is what I do the video on. So majority rules, I completely let you guys decide what each week's video is on, and that's how it's done. Now I'm gonna give you a little bit of context. One of the reasons I started this ministry and made that shift was because due to my criminal record, I have been treated very poorly by almost every, not all, definitely not all, but almost every physical church that I've been a part of. I've been thrown to the side. I've been rejected for things that I was fully qualified for. And it all came down to my criminal record. And I just kept getting stepped on by all these churches, and people in my family that I love, who I won't name, also got stepped on by these churches, and they don't even have criminal backgrounds or anything. So it's basically what happened was I got this huge, horrible frustration with the physical church, in that right now I don't go to a physical church. This ministry has become my church. I meet with a lot of you guys, whether it's a Bible study or an Instagram Live or a Google Hangout, and that's my church. I meet with somebody or a group of people weekly, and it's church, and it's more similar to what church was like in the first century, where there were small groups in people's houses. Essentially, that's what really shoved me to start this ministry, was I felt like God was telling me, if you don't like the way the church is, then do something about it. So I did, and I started this, and I went from, within the past 5 months that I've been doing it this way, I went from less than 1,000 people involved to 15,000 at this point across all social media platforms. What's my end goal? What's the plan? What's the purpose beyond what I'm doing? Basically, I feel called to plant a church. The way that everything has come together since I started doing this in April or May, it's become so evident to me that my purpose is to use this ministry as kind of a foundation or a jumping off point to planting a church. And I'm gonna be in Chicago come spring, God willing. So I plan on planting a church by the end of 2018. And my model for the church is going to look nothing like the churches that you guys are probably a part of. It's gonna be extremely controversial in how it functions and how it's set up and how the services run and in what I teach. And just like I teach on here, I teach things that are very broad. I paint with very broad strokes. And what I mean by that is when I talk about a topic, I don't just give my theological opinion or belief on it. I talk about a broad scope of theological beliefs on any given topic. So salvation, for example, if I was talking about salvation, I would talk about it from a Reformed theological view, from maybe a Catholic theological view, and from an open theist theological view. I wouldn't just tackle it and preach about it from what I believe, because I don't agree with that. I believe that we should teach an assortment of different views, because the church has been split up into 40,000 denominations. And for anybody to think they're right, I think is cocky. Instead of saying that, well, I'm right, my theology is 100% right, even though every denomination says the same thing, I'm just gonna teach everything and let people decide what makes the most sense to them when they look at scripture, when they look at tradition. So that's the end goal, really. And that's hopefully, like I said, by the end of 2018. So that's what it is. That's where it is right now. I'll probably update this channel trailer every 4 to 6 months as things progress, but that's what it is now. That's where I'm going now. Those are my goals now. I'm extremely excited and happy about the way that this has turned out. I've had an opportunity to make so many new acquaintances and friends and do Bible studies and do church with people. It's been amazing. I've had a lot of fun. It's been a total blast, and I'm extremely stoked for what God has for this ministry within this context and within the context of the church that I plan on planting. We're stoked. So that's it. I love you guys. If you're on the fence about what I teach or what I believe, just know that I am too. I'm one of those Christians who's, I'm just honest, like a lot of things don't make sense. So I study them to the best of my ability. I get formally educated in seminary to the best of my ability, but at the end of the day, I can still say I don't know about a lot of things. I'm never gonna shove something down your throat. Well, not ever. I'm not ever gonna shove anything down your throat. There will be times where I give you my opinion and I feel very strongly about it, but I still won't say that I'm 100% right. I'll never say that, because that's just cocky, it's arrogant. I hope this can be a safe place for us to talk about theology, talk about Christian topics, just be open and honest and civil with each other, instead of catty and rude and splitting into denominations. I think the church needs to be Catholic again. And I don't mean Roman Catholic, I mean Catholic. Catholic literally means universal. That was what it was intended to be. So I would like to see the church come back to that, and that we can disagree on things, but still be under one roof, still be in the same building, still loving each other and not talking crap about each other. So that's it. I love you guys. Check out the videos, subscribe, and give me any suggestions you have. I'm always open for feedback, constructive criticism. Let's go. Let's just have fun with it.